One of the consequences of not responding to your medical regime is that drugs may not cross the blood-brain barrier. And that's when you are at risk of dementia at a very early age. Dementia, also called Alzheimer's, or some of it called Alzheimer's, generally happens later on in life, but for HIV-infected gay men, it, in my experience, has happened early on in their 30s, 40s, 50s. And they are typical dementia patients who lose their faculties more rapidly, perhaps, than non-HIV-infected individuals. And to study AIDS dementia, I had to look at the research into syphilis dementia, and they were almost indistinguishable. The spirochete that causes syphilis for many years was thought to be the pathogen that caused AIDS, until we found out it certainly wasn't. Dementia, I'm talking about, that is. AIDS dementia, syphilitic dementia, you can't distinguish, you can't tease out. But if you've ever seen an AIDS patient with dementia, you would never ever again have unsafe sex. You would never again bug chase. You would stop immediately. The greatest disservice AIDS charities worldwide pay to gay men today is to present images of gay men as healthy, hearty, buffed gym bunnies, glossy, beautiful bodies, having great lives, climbing mountains, partying in Sydney, going to the Mardi Gras and looking beautiful. But if they showed people in hospices dying of dementia, or people with lipodystrophy, muscle wasting, lipoatrophy, facial muscle wasting, that would stop them in their tracks. But because we're so politically correct, we feel fear isn't an educator. How come fear is an educator to avoid drink driving, alcohol poisoning, smoking-related diseases and death, but not in HIV? It's because they're so afraid of gay men being offended that they treat us as if we were imbeciles, that they can't show us the truth about the imagery of what having HIV and AIDS is. Having HIV doesn't make you look like Brad Pitt, but it can make you look like an AIDS dementia patient who's dying in hospital. And you don't want to look like that. That actor who played in Midnight Express, Brad Davis, Midnight Express, and the lover of Larry Kramer, you don't look like Brad Pitt, you look like Brad Davis before you die of AIDS dementia. You're shrunken, you're shriveled, but those images aren't sexy. They're not going to sell advertising, but that's the truth of it. And you don't want to mislead the gay community, because what AIDS is not a pretty glossy calendar. If we had a calendar of what people actually look like. There was an interesting magazine out in America called Diseased Pariah News, which was a very scurrilous satirical magazine run by people with AIDS that wanted to frighten HIV negative people into not becoming like them. And they had this thing that made everyone laugh, and I still laugh now to think about it, called the Barbie Hospice, where all the Barbies, you had like Barbie, and you cut out lesions you could put on her, or you could remove limbs, or you could give her pneumonia. A lot of people said, oh my God, you can't do that. You can't have Barbie with Kaposi sarcoma. But these were people with AIDS themselves saying, yes, you can. We want to warn you, don't end up like Barbie in Barbie's hospice with KS and lymphoma and pneumonia. It's not glossy, it's not pretty. It's Brad Davis, it's not Brad Pitt. And you remember when Brad Davis died, no one quite believed he had AIDS because or died of AIDS, because he was a beautiful, beautiful man. Really quite beautiful. Larry Kramer's lover and beautiful actor. Midnight Express, you must remember that. But they showed him as he was in his prime, not as he was before he died. Yeah, if we were honest about the images we showed of what gay men look like when they don't tolerate the drugs, or they don't do well on the drugs, or they are demented or approaching terminal illnesses or death in some way, those images would stop, if anything could, those images would stop gay men becoming infected, because if there's anything gay men are, is vain. We care what we look like. We care what we look like all the time. And the truth is, we don't look pretty when we get ill. Now, those images were out there to help with political correctness. We told the truth about what it is to look that way. That might just be what stops HIV in its tracks. Our vanity might just save our lives.